Have you ever looked at a huge company and just wondered? How on earth do you put a price tag on something that massive? It seems incredibly complex, but it turns out the core idea is actually surprisingly simple. And today, we're going to break it all down.
So how do you do it? How do you actually figure out what a company is worth? I mean, is it their buildings, the stuff they sell, their brand reputation? It feels like this giant, impossible puzzle. But believe it or not, the real answer is way more straightforward than you might think.
You see, it all boils down to a pretty simple formula. At its heart, the value of a company that's traded on the stock market is just a basic bit of math. Let's take a look at the two pieces you need.
To figure out a company's total worth, you really only need to know two key things. Just two. So let's break down what they are.
Okay, first up, we've got the stock price. This one's pretty easy. It's simply the price for one single share of that company's stock that people are buying and selling right now on the open market.
And the second piece of the puzzle, the number of shares. This is just all of them, the total number of shares that the company has ever issued. You can kind of think of it as all the individual slices of the company pie that exist out in the world.
And here is how it all clicks together. You just take the price of one share and you multiply it by the total number of shares. That's literally it. That calculation gives you the company's value. Simple, right? Well, for companies on the stock market, there's a really crucial detail we need to add.
So, what exactly is market value? See, because a company's stock is being bought and sold all the time, its value isn't some fixed number they write down once. It has a special name that really captures its dynamic, always on the move nature.
And that dynamic value is called market value. That first word, market, is the absolute key here. We're not talking about a static number. We're talking about a value that's being determined by the market, moment by moment.
Yeah, this really highlights the big difference. You can think of a basic company value as a single photo, a snapshot in time. But market value, that's a movie. It's a live stream because it's tied directly to that livestock price. It is always, always changing.
So let's dig into that idea, the ever-changing value. This is probably the most important thing to get about publicly traded companies. Their value isn't carved in stone. Nope. It breathes and moves with the market. So what does that actually look like?
So, if the entire market value hangs on that one thing, the stock price, what happens when that price starts to move around? Let's take a look.
Okay, scenario one. Let's say some great news comes out about the company, and suddenly everybody wants to buy its stock. All that demand pushes the price of a single share up.
And because our formula is just price times shares, if the price goes up, well, the total market value of the company goes right up along with it. It's a super direct, super simple connection.
Now, what about the flip side? What if there's bad news, or maybe investors just aren't feeling very confident? Demand for the stock falls, and the price of a single share goes down.
And just like you'd expect from our formula, the company's market value tumbles right down with it. This is the big takeaway here, folks. The fate of a public company's valuation is directly tied to the daily, hourly, and even second-to-second movements of its stock price.
So there you have it. You know the formula. The market value of a public company is just its stock price multiplied by the number of shares. It's a living, breathing number that's always shifting with how people feel. But that leaves us with a fascinating final question. Is a value that changes every single second the same as a company's true worth? That is a topic for another day.
Have you ever looked at a company and just wondered, what's it really worth? Well, it's not some kind of Wall Street magic. Turns out there's a surprisingly simple rule of thumb they use. And by the end of this, you're going to get it too.
All right, let's jump right in. I want to start with a little thought experiment.
So, picture this. There's a company, and it makes a cool 5 million shekels in profit. Every single year, like clockwork. Now the owner wants out, and they're offering it to you. How much do you pay? Seriously, just think about it for a second. What number pops into your head?
Okay, let's play around with a couple of possible answers and see what they really tell us.
All right, first up, let's say you go big. You offer 500 million shekels. That's a huge number, right? Sounds great, but what does that price actually get you as an investor?
Well, think about it. If you pay 500 million and the company makes 5 million a year, you'd have to wait 100 years just to get your money back. 100 years, and that's not even profit. That's just breaking even.
Wow!
Okay, so maybe 100 years is a bit long to wait. Let's try a different number. What if you offered, say, 25 million shekels?
Now, that's a different story.
At 25 million, you make your investment back in just 5 years. 5 years. That feels way more reasonable, doesn't it? You can actually see the path to making real money.
And this really gets to the heart of it, right? It's this constant tug of war. As the buyer, you want that payback period to be as short as possible. 2 years would be amazing. But the seller, of course, they want the highest price they can possibly get. So that final number is always going to be a negotiation, a meeting in the middle.
So this whole concept we've been playing with, the how many years does it take to get my money back thing, it's not just some random idea. It actually has a name. And it's one of the most important tools in an investor's entire toolkit.
It's called the PE ratio, price to earnings, and it's literally what we just did. You take the price of the company and you divide it by its annual earnings. The number you get, that's the PE ratio. It's basically just a fancy way of saying the number of payback years.
And you can flip this around to create a super simple formula for valuing a company. You just take its profit, multiply it by the PE ratio, you know, the number of payback years you're comfortable with, and bam, you've got a rough estimate of the company's value.
So the big question is, what's a good PE ratio? Is 5 good? Is 20 good? Well, it turns out there's no single magic number. It really, really depends on where the company is sold. Is it a private business or is it on the stock market?
Okay, check this out. For private companies, like that little business we talked about, a typical PE ratio is somewhere around 5. Makes sense, right? You want your money back in 5 years. But if you look at the public stock market, the average PE is more like 15. So why on earth are people willing to wait 3 times longer? It all comes down to one thing, growth. On the stock market, you're not just buying today's profits, you're making a bet on what the company's profits will be 5, 10, even 20 years from now. You're paying a huge premium for that future potential.
And that's the thing, this idea of paying for future growth is what makes the stock market go round. But it's also where things can get a little crazy. The PE ratio can become a giant flashing red light that tells you when investors have maybe lost touch with reality.
So let's put this in perspective. Your average stock, like we said, has a PE of maybe 15. A really hot tech stock that everyone's excited about might have a PE of 100. Okay, a long wait, but maybe it'll grow like crazy. But get this, at the peak of the dot-com bubble, there were companies with PE ratios of 3,000. 3,000. That means people were buying stocks knowing it would take 3,000 years of current profits to break even. It's just insane.
And that's what a bubble looks like. When you see numbers like that, it's a massive warning sign. It tells you that the price has become totally disconnected from the company's real-world profits. It's not about value anymore. It's just about pure hype.
All right, let's wrap this up. With just this one simple idea, this one ratio, you've basically unlocked a whole new way to think about how companies are valued. Think about it. You now get the basic idea behind valuing a company. You understand this whole payback period concept. You know exactly why there's a huge difference between private and public prices. And most importantly, you know how the PE ratio can be a warning sign for a market bubble.
So now you've got the tool. You know the formula. So I'll just leave you with this question to chew on. Next time you look at an investment, whether it's a hot stock or just the business down the street, what's it going to be? A bargain or a bubble?